Bienvenue pour la conférence
Welcome
de presse
to the press
de Dipan, film
Dipan,
de Jacques Audiard.
Directed by Jacques Audiard.
Hein?
Bonsoir, bonjour.
Hello.
Bienvenue.
Welcome.
Voilà, merci aux photographes. Je vous présente les personnes à la table en commençant par
podium, starting
à droite, enfin, à votre droite, Pascal Cocheteux, producteur de Wine Note Production.
Personnage important, très bavard, un
français.
Noué
Debré, scénariste, co-scénariste et scénariste en l'occurrence avec Thomas Bigdin et Jacques Audiard, Vincent Routier, comédien. Pardon si j'écorche votre nom.
I'm sorry if I mispronounce your name. Kalisvari Srinivasan,
Jacques Audiard, metteur en scène.
Jacques Audiard, the director.
Anthony
Tazan,
Jesutazan,
actor. And Sima, who will be translating the actors who speak Tamil. Sima will be translating into French.
So,
English-speaking members of the audience are requested to pick up headsets.
Jacques, on dit Jacques, communément qu'on fait un film contre le précédent de Rouillé d'Os.
People often say that your next film is very different from the previous one. I'd like to refer to Rust and Bone. You had leading actors, actresses. Here you've clearly dealt with something different. You've tried out another kind of film with a different technical crew. Andrei Plan isn't there.
Nouvelle chef opératrice.
You have a new director of photography. Actors who are little known in France, if not known at all. The initial project was not to make a totally different film from my preceding one. The project, in fact, came together quite some time ago. When I'd finished filming A Prophet, and the idea matured in my mind, and then thanks to Noé and thanks to Thomas, it gradually matured. The initial idea was not to do something different from my previous film. It was also, in a sense, to do a sort of not a remake of Chien de Paille. But the idea was to approach a love story from a totally different angle. Had you been exploring the theme from the very outset, and the love story was more important than the thriller aspect? Yes. I view films as sort of a Trojan horse, because there's a key topic, and then there's a dark heart beating well within. So indeed,
le genre aurait été un vigilante, une chose comme ça, mais qui est un genre assez stupide.
The genre is quite different here. Gradually, we decided to focus on the couple and this love story. And
well,
I won't talk about the Persian letters. What I wanted to do was to make a French film where people speak Tamil. I really like that idea. The actors are foreigners. I just pushed things quite far. Pascal Cocheteux, what do you think about a French film where people speak Tamil? Were you scared? No, I was quite excited. I wanted to do something totally different. And you said yes right away to Jacques. Oh, you're easy to get along with. Yes, absolutely.
Je me demande ce que je vais demander la prochaine fois.
Well, you better be careful. I'll think up something completely mad to ask him for next time round.
Noé, comment ça s'est passé pour vous?
Noé, what was it like for you? Because the script, as Jacques said, evolved quite a lot. How did you work together in the various stages of the script writing? It was a lengthy process.
Oui, on a commencé il y a vraiment quelques temps maintenant. Et,
we started Jacques quite some time ago. And Jack and Thomas were working together. I saw Thomas quite often.
Il m'apprend beaucoup. Et donc, je voyais Thomas.
I learned a lot from him. So I saw Thomas quite often. I explained what direction I was working in. He rectified things. And then we had a real document. We went to see Jacques. And then we would change everything and start all over again. And we did that any number of times until they'd finished Rust and Bone. And then we really sat down, the three of us together, and the project really began. You don't mind rewriting things in light of the shooting and the actors? Things were done live. Yes, I wasn't on the set, but Elena Krotz, who often works with Jacques, was very present, and there are a few scenes where we did hold meetings to think about them. Indeed, it's a film that really evolved during the shooting. And what about the actors? What about this couple you see in the film? How did you find the actors? Quite frankly, before embarking on the project, I couldn't have even situated Sri Lanka on the map, really. I didn't know what Sri Lankans or Tamils really looked like. I knew very little about the area. And as we proceeded with the casting, things fell into place. Philippe Alcoubi, in charge of casting, found Anthony, who lives in Paris, and then he went to Madras and found Cali. Things fell into place quite quickly. I didn't see 200 people. The actors were chosen quite fast. I hesitated a little bit about the male character, but in fact, things fell into place nicely. The actors are very photogenic. Cali, when Jacques came to see you, what was your reaction? Were you surprised? Were you familiar with Jacques Audiard's films? That's what they did throughout the filming.
Audition kapro inge vande pol okay audition mudinju inge varrathukku prophet paathanaan so appadan theriyum ivar ivar patti plus ivar panna veliye patti
Donc c'était entre le casting et sa venue en France qu'elle a découvert le
I discovered Jacques Audiard's film between the time when the casting took place and the time I came to France.
I was not expecting anything. I just wanted to be open to what he was going to propose because I was the only idea in my mind was that it would be a very great experience. So I had no other, nothing else in mind.
Et du coup, l'expérience, parce que c'était le premier film que vous tournez.
This was the first film you were shooting with Jacques Audiard.
Yes, the first.
Did you enjoy it?
Facile, parce qu'on
was it easy? Apparently, he's very easy to get along with as a director. Can you confirm that?
I loved it. I loved the whole process of the shoot, of the preparation that happened before. And yeah, it is easy if you... Yeah, I don't know. It's easy. Yeah, it's not tough.
Anthony, par contre, vous comédien, vous n'êtes pas comédien professionnel.
You actors are not necessarily professional actors. So I have a question for Kali. Did this request come as a surprise to you?
Non,
பற்றியா இருந்தது. இயக்குனருடைய பேர் அவரை பற்றி எனக்கு கொஞ்சம் தெரியும், ஒரு படம் பார்த்துருக்கிறேன் மகிழ்ச்சியாக இருந்தது. சிரமப்பட்டுத்தான் நடித்தேன், ஆனால் மகிழ்ச்சியாக சிரமப்பட்டு நடித்தேன்.
I wasn't surprised personally to receive this request. I was very happy. I was already familiar with Jacques' films, so I was very pleased. When it came to the acting, it was quite difficult, but it was a joy. It was difficult because you felt that the character was very different from you, or was it the acting per se that struck you as difficult?
எனக்கு எல்லா வேலையும் சிரமமாக தான் இருக்கிறது. நான் கதை எழுதினாலும் எனக்கு சிரமம் தான், நாவலினாலும் எனக்கு சிரமம் தான், பட் இன்னும் எனக்கு சிரமம் தான், எனக்கு எல்லாமே சிரமம் தான்.
Il trouve tout difficile.
I find everything difficult. When I write novels, it's difficult. That's just what it's like. Apparently, all French actors dream of working with Jacques Audiard. Do you confirm that, or following this experience, not at all? Absolutely. Yes, I do confirm. What is specific about being in a film directed by Jacques? Jacques helped us a lot. It's quite special. I turned up on my first day and they'd already been shooting for 3 weeks. And so I had to adjust to the situation. But as it's Jacques Audiard, well, there's always a bit of pressure. But it's okay. I managed to adapt. It's true. It's true that when being in one of his films, it's different perhaps from working with other directors.
Bonjour, Hugues Daillet,
Hugues Daillet, Belgian TV. I have a question for Jacques Audiard.
On voit cet homme, enfin, cette famille artificielle qui a quitté une situation.
You see this artificial family which left a very violent country, yet is confronted with a different form of violence, urban violence. So they move from one form of violence to another. However, you only allude indirectly to this gang war in the housing estates. And also, you don't talk about the military past of your main character.
C'était clair assez, enfin, lors de l'élaboration du scénario.
When drafting the script,
aussi allusif sur les différentes
formes. Had you already decided that you would not focus on the various forms of violence and concentrate more on the family? As I said at the beginning, things evolved a lot. We started working with Noé and Thomas, and the initial script was something we decided to change. I realized that I didn't want to shoot a film according to the first script. However, the intention was not to produce a documentary on this civil war in Sri Lanka. At the same time, I didn't want to produce a documentary on housing estates.
Voilà, c'est donné, c'est comme un papier peint. Vous voyez, ça fait partie de la chose, ça fait partie du
the background,
décor,
that violence, those wars are the background. They're a bit like the wallpaper, if you like. And therefore, this doesn't need to be described.
In
fact, I find it very difficult to indulge in long descriptions. That doesn't come naturally to me. Maybe I should describe things more. Maybe I'm too abstract. But I really can't change. I'll try next time. But the images are self-explanatory. Yes, of course.
Oui, non, mais bon, c'est ce que je disais, c'est que
That's what I was saying.
Ces réalités, jusqu'à quel point on les traite, et puis on s'aperçoit
chemin faisant que c'est de moins en moins intéressant. I didn't want to depict reality per se, because as we started filming, we realized we wanted to focus more on the characters. We wanted the characters to embody this whole story, and that's how the film ended up.
Bonjour, Fali Lagadamassi pour Géopolis.
Bonjour, madame.
Bonjour. J'ai trois petites questions.
I have three short questions for you.
La première est pour Monsieur Anthony Tassin.
First question for Anthony Tassin.
La guerre est finie en 2009.
The war finished in 2009. You were a Tamil tiger. Could you tell us about the national reconciliation process in Sri Lanka? Because that year, for the very first time, the Tamils were able to celebrate the victims of the war in a public manner. And I also have another short question.
Le personnage que vous incarnez, c'est 80% de vous.
Is your character similar to you when you were a child soldier? Does the character resemble you to the tune of 80% or only 20%? And Jacques Audiard, how did Sri Lanka become a starting point for your movie? I have a question for Mrs. Srinivasan as well. In the film, you're the character who embodies the violence between civil war and urban violence. How did you work on your character?
Alors, je sais pas, je vais,
Allez-y, Jacques, commencez.
Alors,
comme
une question m'était posée...
As one of the questions was for me, I'll answer.
À quel moment est venu le Sri Lanka dans l'élaboration du scénario?
When did Sri Lanka occur to me for this film? The historian was Noé. So I'll ask Noé to answer the question.
L'idée de départ, c'est pas la première fois qu'on s'est vu, on n'a pas parlé.
When we met first, we didn't talk about the Tamils. Then we were thinking about making a film
de la violence,
that
en tout cas,
would depict violence.
Qui se dirige vers un film de genre et le renouveau de ça.
We wanted to renew this kind of genre.
Qui allait avoir un peu un impact, un peu une réalité.
We tried to see what would really have an impact in the film. Suddenly, we realized that the Tamils
en fait n'ont pas de représentation de violence dans le cinéma occidental, alors qu'ils viennent d'un lieu extrêmement violent.
Come from a very violent place. But they don't depict violence or have any images in their minds of violence as we construe it in the Western world. So this struck us as good material for a film. These people are running away from a tragedy. I didn't want them to have any links with a post-imperial French situation. I wanted them to come from a long way away, and Sri Lanka was the other end of the earth for me.
Officiellement, en 2009,
officially, in 2009, the civil war in Sri Lanka had come to an end. Even today, however, there are still armed attacks against minorities in Sri Lanka.
Même aujourd'hui, on n'a pas
even
de compte
today,
des prisonniers de guerre.
We don't know how many prisoners of war were captured by the government. We have new news.
L'autre question, c'est sur le
pour lui, il ressemble à 50% à ce personnage du film.
The character is about 50% like me.
Perspectives to two ways or methods of preparation, if you would want to call it that way. One thing is, I live in Chennai, which is very close to Sri Lanka, and we have a history. We still, there is a connection. The politics and the war of Sri Lanka is very much close, how do I say, it's not just simply discussed in Chennai, but it does matter to the Tamil people in Chennai. So I knew to an extent as to what was happening, but of course, I was not there, so there is no way I know the pain, the grief, nothing of war. I've not gone through it, yes. So I just know, which is a bit of knowledge. And then the other way which helped me was, of course, my my theater. I mean, I do theater. After some point, you let go yourself to the story, to your character. Don't ask me how. And it happens after a while that the story takes you along with you, the character takes you along with you. You just have to flow with it. You don't have to do much. It's for me personal. So after a point, the emotions, what would she do in this situation? I'm not sure if it was intellectual. It just happened, and and you just give in, and that's how it is for me. Thank you.
Question là. Allez-y.
Cinéma de Angleterre. Mais je suis né à Sri Lanka.
I was born in Sri Lanka, but I actually work in English. However, I'll put my question in English.
My question is for Jacques. Were you making a political statement saying that portraying Tigers as a organization of freedom fighters when most European countries portray them as a terrorist organization, but were you trying to show another face of it by making a political statement about it?
No, je pense pas. No, je suis assez lâche avec ça.
I'm a bit of a coward in that respect. I didn't want to make a political statement at all.
Quand j'ai découvert ce conflit, cette guerre,
I learned about this conflict, this absolutely horrible war.
Dont d'ailleurs, je crois que toutes les conséquences ne sont pas encore tirées.
And in fact, people are still suffering from the consequences. I was deeply upset when I saw the pictures of the conflict.
Je me suis saisi de la chose simplement.
But I just latched on to
pour toutes les raisons que j'évoquais précédemment.
This situation for all the reasons I explained beforehand.
Qualifier exactement ce conflit.
I can't assess the conflict.
La question tout à l'heure, c'est que je ne suis pas descriptif.
I don't describe things in the film. I provide very little information about the background, this conflict. I think other people can do this better than I.
Mais c'était intéressant de donner.
But it was very interesting to
faire entrer le Sri Lanka, le conflit tamoul dans une fiction.
Bring this conflict into a fiction in my film.
Moi, j'ai vu qu'un seul film qui était sorti.
I saw only one film that was released two or three years ago. There's a Sri Lankan film that was screened in France, and it talks about a tiger returning to his village. That's the only film that I have seen on this topic. And I just wanted to use this, but to make it a fiction.
Bonjour, Alexandre Carigny de Nice Matin.
Alexandre Carigny, Nice Matin.
Vous dites que vous vouliez faire une histoire d'amour.
You said you wanted to do a film on a love story, but the context is very violent. Could you talk to us about your relationship with feelings and violence, which is always omnipresent in your films?
That's odd.
People often ask me this kind of question,
and
I'm always surprised, and I sort of say, well, is it really violent? I don't know. Maybe I take the idea of conflict very literally, and I need this to to whet the feelings, the emotions.
Là aussi. Mais ce qui est intéressant, enfin, ce qui m'intéressait là,
what interested me in this case
de partir de qu'est-ce que c'est qu'une fausse famille,
was
qu'est-ce que c'est
to start
un
with
scénario
a fake family.
De, totalement inventé.
The script was completely invented.
Non, elle n'est pas le père, non, elle n'est pas la mère, non, ce n'est pas leur fille.
He's not the father, she's not the mother. The girl is not their daughter. Yet at the end of the film, they do become a true family. The man, the male character, used to fight for political reasons, and then in the film, he fights for his family and for other reasons. But you always have this verb to fight. To react to this question, one senses that in the film you could have balanced things out more, and you had to choose, it seems, between the love story and the thriller. This film was very interesting for me. I knew I wanted to do it. Right at the beginning of the screenplay, I hadn't fully decided how things would turn out. And then I realized that it would be good to approach the screenplay as though I'd never written it and I didn't really know it very well. That gave me tremendous freedom when making the film, and that was a very worthwhile experience. We had an initial draft, but then the screenplay changed a lot. Thanks to the actors, thanks to how they're reincarnated, so to speak. I often do that when I shoot films, in fact. The script evolves while we work.
In
some films, what you find is that the scenes you actually shoot don't fit in with the screenplay or the initial script. It's like Rust and Bone, which is full of improvisation. About 80 or 90% of what I shot doesn't match what was initially in the screenplay. It's not because they're here today, but every morning I really enjoyed going to see them on the set. We had this translation system, and we tried to appeal to each other and be pleasant. Sometimes I didn't understand a word of what they were saying on the set.
Good morning, Teresa Cruzeiro, ZDF German Television. I have a question to the actor, to Mr. Jetoussa-san. You came to France as well as a Tamil, as a tiger, and I would like to know how it felt for you when you first landed here in France, and if you could bring this feeling to the film. And then I have a question to Monsieur Audiard. Do you think that your film speaks more about the Tamil a war or more about the France nowadays?
Je réponds tout de suite.
I'll answer that question right away.
Je dirais les deux, mon capitaine.
Both of the things you said are true.
Pour moi, c'est un peu métaphoriquement la même chose.
Metaphorically speaking, it's the same thing. We're talking about exactly the same thing.
J'ai l'impression que ma réponse vous satisfait pas du tout.
You don't look very satisfied with my answer. You look a bit disappointed.
Je sais. Alors, répétez-moi votre question.
You repeat your question, please, so I can better prepare my answer.
Si votre film parle plus de la France que ou plus de.
In your film, did you want to talk more about France or more about Sri Lanka? In fact, clearly, we talk more about France in the film. The film doesn't talk about France, in fact.
J'ai attrapé un rhume, je crois.
Sorry, I think I've caught a cold, says the director.
Il parle, c'est le regard, ce sont un ou des regards sur la France.
In the film, you see different views of France. We don't talk objectively about France. You see France as seen through different people.
C'est un film qui est toujours pris dans une subjectivité.
In the film, you always see a given person and his or her views of the world.
Brahim,
for example. Vincent Rottier is called Brahim in the film. Why? This is very representative of France. These housing estates where we shot the film, well, that is France. And we wanted to show France in that manner. What else can I add? I think I've really said everything.
இந்த படத்தில் இருக்கக்கூடிய மாதிரி எல்லா கஷ்டங்களையும் நானும் அனுபவிச்சிருக்கேன். நானும் இந்த படத்தில் வர மாதிரி போலீஸ்காரங்களால் துரத்தப்பட்டிருக்கிறேன்.
Donc, comme dans le film, il a rencontré toutes les difficultés en arrivant en France.
Just as you see in the film, I encountered any number of difficulties when I first arrived in France. I was even chased by the police when I was in the streets.
Bon, je vais traduire.
I'll translate, says Jacques Audiard.
Une autre difficulté que tous les Tamouls Sri Lankais rencontrent, c'est évidemment la
question
de la langue.
Sri Lankan Tamils find it very difficult to speak the language. It's not like Canada or the United Kingdom, where it's a bit easier in terms of learning English. And I still suffer from this today.
Il est encore en France, il est arrivé en France parce que
I came to France because at the time I was able only to find a fake French passport and not a fake English or British passport.
Mais c'est des vies aventureuses, hein. On est des nains.
It's a life full of adventure.
L'acteur a répondu à la question que je voulais faire. Dans tous les cas, à la fin du film,
at the end of the film,
les personnages intégrés,
we see the characters who seem very well integrated in England. Are you trying to say that it's easier in England or in Canada to find one's rightful place? No, that's not what I intended at all. Right from the very beginning of the film, the female character says she wants to go to England, and she finally manages to do so. So she says and she repeats that she wants to go to England, and in the end she goes. I wouldn't venture to compare England and France in terms of integration. I'm not very sufficiently familiar with the French system, let alone the English one. And look, Anthony is still here in France.
Après, je pense qu'il y a des grandes destinations. Arrête-moi si je me trompe. Il y a des grandes destinations.
Correct me if I'm mistaken, but I believe that the Tamil diaspora went mainly to Canada. I think some people have come to France and England as well. Those are the three main destinations. One can understand why people from Sri Lanka go to the English-speaking world, including Australia. It's because of the English. From a linguistic stance, it's easier.
From the Buenos Aires, Harold.
Bonjour.
Quel beau pays.
I like the film very much. Just want to ask whether you think maybe the screenwriter could tell us whether there is a subtext here of trying to deal with the experience of immigration to Europe in general. And I have some issues about the end of the film, which seems to be an idealization of the experience of integration, which is so far different from reality. In a way, so it is as if towards the end of the film, there is a rescue of the Holy family together with a new child as the Messiah who will kind of rescue everybody.
Well, of course, the film does talk about immigration and the difficulties integrating in
et focaliser sur la famille
the country.
Et sur
but at the end of the film we focus on the family.
Moi la lecture que j'en ai au moment où je vois le film
when I see the film
c'est maintenant c'est un peu loin mais
because of course I wrote the script a long time ago and it evolved but what I see is that the country they finally find is their home
comme leur terre d'accueil.
The country where they end up is the final country where they establish their real home. The country is their family in a way. Do you agree, Jacques? Yes, I absolutely agree. the focus at the end is the family.
Formellement, d'un strict point de vue de la mise en scène, la façon
in
dont
terms
vous avez travaillé cette fois-ci, parce que
the way you worked on your film this time,
bien,
of course, depending on your
choses,
film, you like trying new things. But what were the formal decisions you made in terms of the directing?
Je devais avoir certains partis pris de.
I had to start with
d'image, de lumière,
some definite ideas about the images and the lighting, and then everything changed during the actual shooting.
Je sais pas comment dire ça. C'est un film
how can I say this?
Qui a passé son temps à accepter un certain nombre de choses et donc à en refuser beaucoup d'autres. Et tous les effets,
we kept adding things to the film and removing things. There are some things we tried to add to the film which the film didn't want. The film developed antibodies, so to speak, and rejected certain things.
Et après, il y a des choix qui se font.
Of
oui,
course,
le cinémascope,
choices
le
were made.
Si on parle, je trouve que c'est toujours bien quand on parle.
I think it's
quand on
always
a
good idea when you have
images, voilà,
these little heroes
sinon,
on the screen. You need to give them broad and wide images.
C'était de tout ce qui avait été véritablement trop pensé au départ.
Things that were too carefully thought through at the outset. In the end, didn't work out in the film. Do you have any more precise examples? Oh, it's hard to come up with examples at 10:30 in the morning.
Non, dans les expériences les plus récentes, ça j'en ai souvenir. Je vais essayer de réfléchir.
I'm trying to think about what I can answer. During the editing,
le film acceptait la musique.
I realized that the film accepted music,
par exemple, je pouvais pas faire du Bora Bora avec, je pouvais
but
pas,
not from end to end.
La musique ne pouvait pas être
the music couldn't be too lyrical, too overly present, except for the very beginning and the end. The film didn't accept certain things. The film made its own choices. Similarly, in terms of movement. When there was too much steadicam, the film didn't like it. When things became too pretty, too romanesque, too sophisticated, when we were too careful with the framing, for example, during the indoor scenes, the film didn't like certain things. It was very strange. What about the music? Alexandre Desplat was involved, huh?
C'était aussi une façon de changer ou un problème d'agenda.
Way of changing, was it a problem of agenda?
J'avais envie de sur ce projet-là, mais
well, with this film,
Alexandre est un.
Well, may I say first of all that I work with Alexandre for 10 or 20 years. He's a real friend and someone who I truly admire. What he did with Grand Budapest is quite phenomenal. No, I needed to change a little bit. I needed to change the images, the music. I had to bring in changes in order to remain creative. If you work too long with the same people, well, I love the people, of course, but people know what you want only too well, and there's no element of surprise. The film was finished quite late on. Yes, absolutely.
On arrive à supporter
non, pas du tout.
It must have been there must have been a lot of pressure. Yes, that's
non,
really rough.
Justement, ces délais ou cette urgence parfois profite à
or when
des choses.
You really have to hurry, can that be beneficial?
C'est j'ai du mal quand, voilà comment tout à l'heure avec nous on parlait de c'est un projet qui est né
this is a project
tout début il y a 3 ans 4 ans donc j'arrive là
which occurred to me about 3 or 4 years ago.
C'est très long.
It was a very, very lengthy process. And so at a given point, I'm in a hurry to finish. We were selected here for Cannes. That in itself is quite incredible. It forced us to really move fast. And we did. When things move fast, you think less, and I like that. Sometimes it's good to stop thinking, regretting things. It's very tiring. There's some things that I might like to rework in the film.
Oui, c'est ça, comme on dit.
Okay, à moins qu'il y ait une toute petite
unless there's one final question. Yes, go ahead, sir.
Pardon, le micro, attendez le micro. Attendez le micro.
Pourquoi ce goût pour les héros en perdition, souvent, des fois,
why do you so love these heroes who are doomed to fail, to encounter problems? You often talk to people who are already losing in life and you try to save them. It's a very interesting process to film. If the idea is to go from A to B or S to T, what's the point? What's good is to go from A to Z. These people who are failing, in fact, offer the greatest scope when it comes to drama and conflict.
Merci beaucoup, merci.
Thank you very much.
Merci bien, bonne journée.
Très aimable. Merci beaucoup.
Voilà, c'était donc la conférence de presse de Dipan de Jacques Audiard. On va revenir maintenant en attendant l'équipe.
That was a press conference for the Audiard film. We are waiting to see the next film in competition, but in the meantime, let's take a look at what happened.